on Friday, May 31st, 2019, I'd like to open up the meeting for the Length of Service Awards Program. LoSAP.
Did we tell?
We have a call to order. Okay, and roll call. And do we have a motion to accept the agenda?
I'll make a motion to accept the agenda.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Okay. Then we have a, we have the, approve the amendments for February 22nd, 2019. If you want to review them, and then I'll take a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes of February 22nd, 2019.
I'll second.
All right, we have a first and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. All right, now we have our presentation from Asset Strategy on the quarter ending March 31st.
Good morning. First of all, thank you for having us here. Just to give you a little history, this portfolio, we finally are at 100% invested at this point in time.
Oh,
so congratulations on that. And just as a reminder, this portfolio was started in February of 2018, and the strategy was to dollar cost average into the market over a year or so. And so as we had a down market in fourth quarter of 2018, higher cash balance really helped our performance. I think we were down maybe 5% for the quarter, while the rest of the market was up, you know, low double digits, or DAP was down low double digits. So it was a help for us, buffered, you know, volatile market, but it also gave us the opportunity to buy and initiate some positions, which we did in the fourth quarter. And then our last big investment was at the end of January. And so if you'll turn to page, I'll start on page 3. So now that we are within, there's a couple of things I would point out in terms of the portfolio allocation. If you will notice the upper chart there on the right-hand column, the last column there, you can see that we're within our policy allocation. Previously, we were we were underweight in the small mid equity, and we were overweight in cash. Now everything is in line. You can see that the policy allocations there, that target versus where we are currently, and this is as of the end of March, obviously. And I have a market value update to show you where we stand today. But just a point of reference that we were 11.6% cash at the end of fourth quarter. Now that's down to 1.8% in cash. So we're there within policy. My only question would be, just in terms of keeping cash in the account, is there a minimum amount that we should think about should be kept there for any expenses or anything of that nature? Open for any comment or suggestions for that, because I see that our policy is set at zero, but we're within our range, so it's not causing any issues there. So it's just a general question. If ever there's a concern that we need to put that cash to work and invest it and actually get that down to zero, we can do that.
Okay. Right. Well, I'm new, so you know, I don't have any real questions yet.
Okay.
I don't know enough to ask a question.
Well, if you think of anything, you're very observant, so I'll wait for any questions that you may have. So let's look at performance. So if we go to page 2, you can see for the quarter, you know, the portfolio generated 8.4% return from a total portfolio perspective, which was in the 78th percentile. I would attribute part of that to the fact that, you know, January was a pretty strong month in the market. So, again, we were still overweight cash at that point in time. I think we invested that last tranche of cash around the 20th of January. So we did get the benefit of some of that, but we did get the benefit of February and part of March. And so so now that we are fully invested, I would expect our, you know, our peer rankings to, you know, to improve. Just like we spoke of the retirement plan, now that we've got cash, we should see our improvement in our peer rankings as time goes on. Right now, in terms of holding, it's all passive. So on a net of fee basis, it's very, very much a nice risk return type of allocation that we're in. Again, balancing, equity, fixed income, both, emerging market and international. So right now, the portfolio set, we will certainly have more discussions as we move on. If we have any additions of cash, we will certainly talk about where that needs to go. Any needs for cash, we'll talk about any sources that we need to come up with.
The commissioners did approve their 2020 budget and included in the Emergency Services Support Fund was an additional $1 million for the trust as of July 1. So
we can make that transfer.
Yes. So we can make that transfer after the beginning of the next fiscal year.
Okay, great.
And then that'll give you, probably have that in time for the August meeting.
Okay, great. We will look for that and put that to work.
Where do you see it going?
We'll just evenly distribute it, so okay. It'll take the balance up. We'll just keep it within line where we are now.
Yeah, I think what we're trying to accomplish there is this fund's underfunded, and we're focusing on maybe raising the profile, raising the amount that's in there. OPEB is well above what our range should be. Mm-hmm. This is well below.
Okay.
And I think we're about 13, 15 million?
Below.
Yeah, below on this one. And again, we have a fund balance that has unassigned funds in it. We keep a 15% policy, and we're above that. And we just went on a buying spree and bought some turf fields and animal shelter and this and that.
Mm-hmm.
But we may want to turn around and invest it back into the open.
That would be part of the 2021 budget.
I'm just Commissioner Hewitt talking, but. The point is that I still believe the metrics that impacted our fund balance this year will impact it again but this is where I see at least recommending to other commissioners. It takes three of us to make a decision, but mm-hmm. LOSAP is probably one that we need to start putting a little bit more toward.
Sure. And as you just from observation, our fixed income allocation is a little higher than we have in the OPEB portfolio. Mm-hmm. And it's just for what you said, we want to be, because it's underfunded, we want to make sure that we don't want to take too much risk.
Yeah.
So that's all I really have. Very short comments. So any questions? If not, thank you again.
Any questions for assets?
Tell me, are you doing this for anybody else, this type of a low SAP? We're the only guys.
But as you add the $1 million, we're not going to come back and ask for more money.
Yeah. Well, I think it's kind of interesting that how this works in the community. My wife just joined the local volunteer fire department auxiliary. And, of course, the thing was, you get to 50 points,
right,
and you're going to get this credit on. So she's baking cakes. She said, I'm trying to get my 50 points, And I was like, look, honey, we're going to be okay. but we both come from humble beginnings. And her point is, I do two chocolate cakes. I get 3 points. She's got to get to 50. And bottom line is, it's just such a great thing
for
the people who volunteer and do this thing as a volunteer service for us. That it's, so the only thing I've been told is we're working the whole carnival this year.
What did you say? We?
Yeah. 6 days.
Hollywood?
Yeah,
okay.
6 days.
We'll be there.
Yeah.
Anyway. We'll verify the points.
Huh? Yeah, really, please.
All right, do we have a motion to accept the asset strategy report?
So moved, or second if it's already been made.
I think we need a second.
Second.
All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Great. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you all. We really appreciate it.
Then it looks like the next thing is our committee report. Jody?
Okay, this is a short report.
So the administrative payments that have gone out since our last meeting is one payment, first quarter 2019 invoice to Asset Strategy for $1,000. Our future meetings for LOSAP is August 30th, 2019 and December 6th, 2019. Alrighty, do we have a motion to accept the plan administrator's report?
So moved.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Alright, we have no old business, and we have new business, the same. Catherine on the proposed joint investment manager for this board.
Yes, thank you. So I would ask the board to vote in support of submitting a consent agenda item to the commissioners to enter into a joint RFP for an investment manager.
Motion that we enter into commissioners' consent agenda for a joint RFP for a
combined investment manager.
Combined asset manager.
For the three retirement trusts.
We have a first, do we have a second?
I'll second.
Alright, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. And that is the end of our meeting, so do I have a motion to end the meeting, to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn the meeting.
Second.
Second, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you.